name's Vincent from AirGunsEurope.com, and in this video I'm going to be telling you a little bit about the Gammo Hunter 1250 Grizzly Pro IGT, which is quite a mouthful, but this is one of Gammo's most powerful brake barrel air rifles. This one, along with the normal 1250 G Magnum, the Replay and the Jungle, only this is the only one which has a really nice wooden stock on it. The stock is ambidextrous, so both good for left and right handed shooters. It's got really nice checkering on its grip and on its forearm. Also, the air rifle has got the custom action trigger in it from Gammo, which is an adjustable trigger. It's got the rubber ventilated butt pad, which you can take these things out to give it a little less recoil. And the thing I like about this air rifle is that it's got the new 33mm cylinder, and that, along with the gas piston which is in here, the IGT gas piston, make it a really powerful air rifle. Now, Gammo says that this air rifle has got a muscle energy of up to 45 joules with a muscle velocity of up to 380 meters per second. Unfortunately, that's not really true. If I put it to the chrono, it'll get you up to 38 joules of muscle energy and around 280 meters per second of muscle velocity, which is still quite high for a 5.5 millimeter brake barrel air rifle, of course. It's really powerful. It's got a recoil reduction rail mounted on top, so if you want to mount the scope, you can simply place it on here, but make sure you mount a really proper scope, because otherwise it'll break because of the recoil of this air rifle. A scope is not included on this air rifle, but it has got really nice open sights on it, which are equipped with the Tuglo fiber. And the rear sight is both adjustable for windage and elevation, of course. It's quite a long air rifle. It's 131 centimeters. It weighs 3.8 kilograms, so it's not the lightest of air rifles. And of course, it's quite powerful, so not for the small backyards or anything like that, but it's a really nice thing to shoot with. And because of the fact that this one has the IGT gas piston in it, the cocking effort isn't that heavy, not as heavy as you would expect from a big air rifle like this one. Let's take it to the range and we'll test it. Alright, so we're down at the range, ready to test fire it. If you want to load the air rifle, you simply put it in your hip, cock it all the way through. Now, the cocking effort is quite less on this air rifle, especially since it's quite a powerful one. The pellets I'm using today is the H&N Hornet, which is quite a demolition pellet, as I always say, because it's got a copper tip to it, and it'll shoot through anything, actually. Also, I like the pellets from H&N and JSB. The JSB Heavy Exact is quite an accurate pellet for this air rifle, but if you just want to shoot stuff and break things, the H&N Hornet or the Predator Polymark is quite a nice pellet for it. Now, the gun has got a manual safety on it, located in front of the trigger, like we used to with Gammo. If you want to put it on safety, simply pull this back and the trigger won't work. Push it forward and now it's ready to go. Yeah, quite nice. Also, all the metal parts on the outside of the air rifle have got a blued finish on it. So make sure to keep that clean, because otherwise you will get rust on there. Yeah, you can feel the power of the IGT piston, because they go forward really fast, way faster than a normal spring would. And because of the fact that this one has a wooden stock, it absorbs a lot of the recoil on the air rifle, so it's quite good. Also, it's a thing you have to like or don't like. Some people rather have a synthetic stock on it, but I personally think it has a classic look to it. I'm gonna shoot a bit more, and thank you for watching this video. See you next time.